I'm Apurva Desai. I'm a level C coach. I've done a lot of camps. I specialize in batting and work with a lot of first-class players, a lot of junior players, specifically on the skills or tactics of the game when it comes to working on their batting, say from the junior level right up to the international level. Str8bat as a tool has helped me in a lot of ways to make my sessions more efficient. Firstly, it's very easy to use. Secondly, it gives me instant feedback on what they're doing. Plus, what happens is I can allow the batsman to express himself and the data is real. Because a lot of times what happens is you put a camera and you record a session, he becomes conscious. But with a sensor on the bat, what happens is he's just allowing his free game to go through, and we have data of every ball. I mean, Str8bat, what happens is you've got a sensor here which is stuck on the player's bat, and then they've got data. So what all do we get in Str8bat? I get my bat angle when I initiate my backlift. I get my bat path. I get the accelerated downswing. So every time once the bat downswing starts, I get the bat speed which should accelerate it. Towards when I reach the impact point, it goes into yellow, orange and red zone. At impact, I get my bat angle that proves whether I'm on top of the ball or not. I also get a wagon wheel. I also get whether the ball was played on the ground or above the ground. So imagine a guy playing a session on his own. I'm not there and he's just practicing on his own. But I still get data onto whether he's drives or whatever stroke he wants to play, what you call it, even if it's a full shot, getting data every time whether he lifted the bat properly or not. I get bat speeds, and most importantly I get impact speed. I also get, so if you combine all the data, the most important is I also get the reps in. So every session can be monitored and I can take as much data as possible. So if I did a session today for 500 balls, I did a session after 10 days for 500 balls, I still have that data with me.